So today we are going to be looking at lesson 5, which is day 15. So our learning target for today is I can read pages 14 and 15 of the text Groundwater and answer text-dependent questions. So we're just changing the page numbers from yesterday, but the same thing. So text-dependent questions mean we need to look back in the text to find the answers. They're going to be there. So today we're going to be reading pages 14 and 15 and answering text-dependent questions. So the first thing we're going to be doing is reading it in the text. So I will be reading it in this video, or you can click the link to go to the groundwater text and read it yourself. So, page 14. Future focus. Record drought forced California to conserve water. In just 6 months, people there went from using as much as 140 gallons or 530 liters per person to just 67 gallons or 254 liters a day on average. Across the United States, small changes in water can save hundreds of gallons in the average American home each week. This diagram is titled The Trouble with Toilets. Did you know that toilets use more water than anything else in your house? They do, according to a 2016 study of water use inside 23,749 homes spread across the United States, but not as much as they did in a similar 1999 study. Newer, more efficient toilets help send less water into the sewer. Some families also practice selective flushing. That means that they don't flush the toilet each time they use it. So we can look right here. This is the gallons per household per day. So for a toilet, they average 33.1 gallons per day. For shower and bath, 31.7 gallons per day. For a faucet, 26.3 gallons per day. For the clothes for your washer, 22.7 gallons per day. And for your dishwasher, any leaks or other miscellaneous water usage, 23.9 gallons. Page 15. By installing low flush toilets and taking shorter showers, we can use less groundwater. Another small effort that we can save gallons is running only full loads in washing machines and dishwashers. Some people are also saving water by replacing thirsty grass in their yards with plants that need less water. Saving our groundwater isn't easy. People need to drink. Farmers need to irrigate crops to grow our food. Still, we can be smarter about how we use this resource, both now and far into the future. So our picture right down here says some Los Angeles homeowners swapped grass for other plants in the dry summer of 2014. So now we need to look at our questions. What do you think the main ideas of page 14 and 15 are? What details did you find to support the main idea? So remember, the main idea is finding these big ideas of what it's mostly about. So looking at our headings, which is future focus, can help us know what we are reading about. We can also look at the first and last paragraph. Sometimes that can give us a clue, but ultimately we're trying to find what this section is mostly about and the details to support it. After that, we have some questions to answer. According to groundwater, what are ways to conserve water? And what details in the text support your answer? So if we look over at the day 15 checklist, you're typing your answer to the main idea, the evidence or examples to support your thinking. According to the text, meaning you're looking back in your text, what are ways to conserve water, and what details from the text helped you answer this question? So go ahead and complete those now.